Hello everyone. Today we're going to go over how to create a hybrid backup job within NovaBackup. So just as a little bit of reference, I've already created a NAS device that I'm going to go to along with a cloud storage device that I'm going to go to. So those are the prereqs, obviously having NovaBackup installed, registered, all that fun stuff. But I have the NAS and cloud storage set up. I'll go to the backup tab. I'm just going to select what I want to back up. In this case, I'm going to select this folder. It has a bunch of stuff that I want to back up in it. And then I'm going to go to the backup to location. So the first thing it does is the hybrid backup wants to back up to, I'll call it the local device, or in this case, a NAS. It could be like a USB drive or USB key, what have you. But it's going to back up to that first. And then after that, you want to go to the settings tab or settings button. And here's where it kind of, where the magic kind of happens here. We want to enable the hybrid backup. And in the hybrid backup configuration, you want to choose the NovaBackup cloud storage device or whatever cloud storage location you have set up. And in here, you get to determine how long to keep data in each location. So say, for instance, I only want to keep versions of data for the last 15 days on my local NAS, and in the cloud I want it to keep it, I don't know, like 90 days. This means any versions or changes of files that I back up will be restorable from the local device, you know, very quickly and very easily, whereas if I need to go back a little bit further, it would automatically restore from the cloud. And I'll click OK here. I'm just going to name the actual backup job, just call it hybrid backup. And then I'm going to save that. Then I'm just going to click backup. First thing it's going to do is go to, obviously, that NAS device that I have set up here. It'll just take a couple seconds. It's a pretty small backup. After that's done, it's going to start going to the cloud. It's going to say archiving. Basically, it's going to mount that local backup job, a local backup that it just did, and connect to the cloud, and then it's going to actually start sending data from there. So it's not having to back up that data again from the local machine to the cloud. It's actually coming directly from the backup that you just did. And then after it's done, it'll check to see how big it is, and that's pretty much all there is.